28th, St. Peter Nolasco, founder of the Order of Our Lady of Ransom. Peter, of the noble family of Nolasco in Languedoc, was born about the year 1189. At the age of 15, he lost his father, who left him heir to a great estate, and he remained at home under the tutelage of a mother who encouraged all his good aspirations. Being solicited to marry, he set himself out first to ponder seriously the vanity of earthly things, and rising one night, full of those thoughts, he prostrated himself in prayer, which continued until morning. He then consecrated himself to God in the state of celibacy and dedicating his whole patrimony to his service. The Moors at the time were masters of a great part of Spain, and numbers of Christians who had been made slaves groaned under the tyranny both there and in Africa. Compassion for the poor had always been the distinguishing virtue of Peter. The pitiful spectacle of those unfortunates and the consideration of the dangers to which their faith and virtue stood exposed under their Mohammedan masters touched his heart, and he soon spent his estate in redeeming as many as he could. By his fervent appeals, he moved others to contribute large alms toward this charity, and at last formed the project of instituting a religious order to maintain a constant supply of men and means whereby to carry on such a charitable undertaking. This design encountered many difficulties, but it is said that Our Lady appeared to St. Peter, to the King Aragon, and to St. Raymond of Penafort in distinct visions on the same night, and encouraged them to carry the scheme into effect under the assurance of her patronage and protection. St. Raymond was the spiritual director both of St. Peter and of King James, and a zealous promoter of this work. The king declared himself protector of the order and assigned them quarters in his own palace. On August 10, 1223, the king and St. Raymond conducted St. Peter to the church and presented him to the Bishop of Barcelona, who received his three religious vows, to which the saint added a fourth, to devote his whole substance and his very liberty, if necessary, to the work of ransoming slaves. The like vow was enacted of all his followers. St. Raymond preached on the occasion, and declared that it had pleased Almighty God to reveal his will to King James, to Peter Nolasco, and himself, enjoining the institution of an order of the ransom of the faithful detained in bondage among the infidels. St. Peter received the new habit from St. Raymond, who established him first master general of the order, and drew up for it rules and constitutions. Two other gentlemen were professed at the same time with St. Peter. When Raymond went to Rome, he obtained from Pope Gregory IX in 1235 the confirmation of the foundation and its rule. St. Peter ordained that two members should be sent together amongst the infidels to treat about the ransom of captives, and they are hence called ransomers. One of the two employed at the outset in this way was the saint himself, and Valencia was the first place which was blessed with his labors. The second was Granada. He not only comforted and ransomed a great number, but his charity and example was an instrument of introducing many Mohammedans to embrace the faith of Christ. He made several other journeys to those regions of the coast of Spain which were held by the Moors, besides a voyage to Algiers, where he underwent imprisonment. But the most terrifying dangers could never make him desist from his endeavors for the conversion of the infidels, burning as he was with a desire of martyrdom. St. Peter resigned the office of ransomer and master general some years before his death, which took place on Christmas Day, 1256. In his last moments, he exhorted his religious to perseverance and concluded with those words of the psalmist, "The Lord hath sent redemption to his people. He hath commanded his covenant forever." He then recommended his soul to God, appealing to the charity which brought Jesus Christ from heaven to redeem us from the captivity of the devil. And so he died, being in the 67th year of his age. His relics were honored by many miracles, and he was canonized in 1628.